Hey y'all, it's Chris Celeste, and I just killed the interview with the best interviewers in Broward County. Matter of fact, in Florida, period. Thanks for having me, y'all. It was lit. Y'all check that out. Hit back 3954. Link in their bio. Tell me what y'all think.
Again? Another one?
Yeah. I feel bad that I did well, but I was not feeling myself that day. I was like, ooh.
Yeah.
I struggled just to even get to the party. I was like, I'm here.
Shit, crazy.
Man. It was rough. So, whatever.
So, how was weekend, though?
See? Weekend was pretty dope. I liked it. Easter Sunday, you know, Sunday was nice with the family and the friends. Saturday, yeah. It turned up. 420 party, you know, I had to be there. Even though I was sick, but, you know. Friday night.
It was a real smoke session, but I can't find it was a real smoke session.
Hell yeah, everybody was smoking out there. Everybody was so stoned, there was no dancing. Which is kind of, I was like, damn. I wanted like some dancing, but I mean, everybody was so high, it was just like, what?
It was perfect, yeah, it was perfect for the storm music. Even my friends were like, dang, he's a good DJ. And I'm like, I know, girl, stop it.
Oh, speaking of that, shout out to, the mixtape just dropped.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for real,
dude. Yeah, man. The devil tried to keep me from dropping it, but I had to drop it.
Yeah.
Oh, I celebrated my friend Maria Globotón's birthday.
Yeah. She's hard now.
On Friday, I'm celebrating her, so shout out to her. Happy birthday, Maria.
Happy birthday.
Mama, the IG model friends, you know, turn up.
Hey.
Turn up in style, so that's it.
Shout out to Danny and them had They Crave Cookie as a special guest today on the show.
Oh, yeah, shout out to that, man. Shout out to, you know, Danny, them show always on point, always lit. You know, they had special guests today, so that was lit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got a special guest today.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, speaking of that, we got a special guest today, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Chrissy coming through. It's going to be lit. Talk to her.
And she lit, too, bro.
Yeah.
Y'all she lit. Ready.
I mean, the last one we had was lit too. Her little ass was lit.
Yeah.
I wasn't there.
I know.
You talking about Jaya?
Yeah. Well, she was cool though, man. She was lit as fuck.
Yeah.
She was real lit.
Yeah, I like the one that I did with the other one. She was dope too.
Oh, you talking about Gabby?
Gabby, cool. Yeah.
That's
what I missed.
You
missed that one.
Yeah.
That one was dope.
But see, I've met Gabby plenty of times. That's the homie. She cool. Okay. Yeah.
She's just real chill.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
She's not that real stone up tomboy girl.
Yeah. She gave me like that cool stone. I like that vibe though. It's kind of cool. It doesn't like, you know, like.
Plus, she's sexy.
Yeah, she pretty.
She.
Listen, first of all, this is what I'm going to tell you why she's sexy. You know, I'm not a big fan of dark skinned chicks.
Yeah.
Skin tone. She's manipulated.
Oh, yeah. She definitely got melanin all day.
Soft, mocha brown.
Yeah.
Don't be saying that. You like dark skin.
She got some. Yeah, you gotta be careful when you sit on the air. You gotta be careful when you sit on the air.
I like chocolate.
Mm-hmm. I like them all, baby. Yeah, chocolate chip, light skin caramel.
I mean, I like them all. I don't discriminate, but. I mean,
Spanish mommies.
Spanish mommies.
I like Spanish mommies.
She got long hair, you know.
I can deal with the
long hair going on.
Yeah, okay. Snow buns. I deal with the snow buns, but the Spanish mommies, the caramel, the dark, yeah. All day.
The Dominicans,
Oh yeah.
Stop playing.
Oh yes, sir.
They'll hit you with a pan right quick.
She's a man. Hey. I can't fuck with no crazy woman. Mm-hmm.
You should have hollered at my friends. We had some Cubans, we had Dominicans, we had all of them.
I seen them over there, y'all. They was lit. I seen them over there dancing.
They could throw money and shit. They'd be like,
yeah, shout out Odell, this motherfucking bitch.
Right, ew.
Hey, listen, Odell Taco, boy, they be selling out. I've been hitting this phone up like, hey, bro, we gonna be out tonight. I need some tacos.
Yeah?
Is that serious?
Oh, shit.
Okay. Is that serious, bro? Well, you know what time it is. If I hit up a vendor, though.
Aren't you fasting? Night, are you still fasting?
Nah, that was. Well, I am, but I can eat like once or twice a day.
Oh, okay.
It's a limit, like, it's a time limit.
You can only eat like once a day.
No, it's a time limit. 16 hours, no eating, and 8 hours of eating. So between that 8-hour limit, I can still eat. Yeah. So, it's been working too, man. I've been, you know what I'm saying? The gym and all that, man. You know, flexing. But, yo, I ain't gonna lie, my arms hurting. It's 2 days ago, I was in the gym heavy, so, yeah.
Okay, party, y'all. Okay.
Get it in.
I know you fasting too. Oh, God.
I'm gonna fast some tacos. Yes, sir.
Ain't fast.
Shit, yeah, it is.
I I said, I'm not fasting.
Oh, you ain't fasting?
No. You eating right now. What you snacking on?
Some snacks.
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought. That's the food at the 420 party, though. That shit was fire. Oh, yeah. That potato salad. Stop it.
Hold on. Is it the same 420 party?
Yes, sir. Yeah. You missed out.
And
Savage Cato.
What was I?
That was so good.
You heard me? We had Savage Cato.
Oh, yeah?
It's his restaurant cato with the ribs, chicken, macaroni, cheese.
At the factory joint?
No.
Oh, it's not okay. I don't know about the other part of it.
Our event, not his.
No. Oh.
Let me tell you something. That macaroni and cheese off the chain. And so the ribs, too. You missed out.
Man, I ain't know the food there. I definitely would have came through.
See, your Factory Dame was on there. That should have been more of a reason.
Well, you know.
And I was hosting it and I
got some. And Fatima was there.
Nah,
you know. Let me dog by herself.
I ain't gonna lie to you.
But don't.
At one of them nights, at one of them days, it was a recovery day. Put it that way.
Okay.
I was in bed pretty much all day.
Oh shit. Okay.
That's why when you was like no show, I was like thank you, Jesus. I was dead, bro. Now for real, I was like, man, I'm glad he said that again, right? Because woo. I got up at 11 o'clock just to make it to the show, but then there was no show, so I said yes, right back to sleep. I slept all day. Now real talk, I slept all day, bro. Like.
I did that Sunday. I felt so bad Saturday, and yeah. I slept in like so like. Hey.
And then when I got up, I hit my brother up. I need a couple of joints, 420.
Obviously.
You know what I'm saying?
I smoke at 420. On 420, I smoke weed.
Oh yeah. Mm. It's only right.
I had some fun facts for the party, but I feel like the party was a little bit late, like 9 o'clock. Like everybody's so stoned.
Yeah.
We had to have that shit like at 2 o'clock, so everybody's still alive.
Yeah.
By 12 o'clock, everybody was already high. Shit.
I thought everybody's eyes was Asian. Everybody was Asian.
Like, I forgot to mention, Friday, I actually brought sis out to the spot, bro. I brought sis out just to introduce two new tracks. The Major Nine, Mike Smith joint.
Where?
The lounge.
Who?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I brought her out. She introduced that. She introduced the other one, too. The True Player For Real. So, yeah. You know, Bree played the songs. She had fun. She don't be going out that much no more, but when she go out, she turn up, so.
Get drunk, turn up.
Yeah. I mean, she put a lot of hard work in, so might well show her a good time every now and again, little sis. You know? And, yeah, man, she's definitely one of the highest producers in the game, and bless you.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
Man, you know, gotta show her a good time every now and again. You know, little sis deserve it. So, but yeah, that was your weekend. Pretty dope for Tama. My weekend was seemed like it was dope making money.
You already know, having a little fun, you know?
Yeah. Shout out to all the stoners.
Oh, I forgot. What? Last Tuesday, I DJed at the office.
How was
Damn.
That?
That was lit.
I'm so mad I didn't have any friends in that town. I would have so freaking gone somewhere.
I had told Fat to pull up too.
I'm mad.
It was lit though. I fucks with it. It was definitely
I'm sure you had that thing bumping.
Oh yeah, of course. So I was gonna have a shit crazy.
Oh yeah, we were vibing.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was dope.
Yeah, so.
Shout out to Danny B though. We took a picture at the 420 party.
Yeah,
that's the one that do the early Monday show.
Yeah, okay, the Today Show.
I see she
right?
got some makeup thing in May, makeup award or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. She got nominated.
Pretty dope.
Like that.
Ooh, that's what I'm talking about.
She's grinding.
She's doing my own thing, you know.
Come on, man. She learned from the greatest. Come on, man.
Okay. She learned a model from the greatest?
Man, you gotta know how to teach them again.
She said she learned from the greatest. What, model? I'm talking about the hustle, man.
I'm talking about the hustle.
I'm gonna learn a lot from you then.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, you just said it. You like, oh, somebody see you at Capone's, like, oh, you the girl that's hosting, you know.
Yeah, I see your booty. I didn't know if you were a friend. I was like,
yeah.
I looked at him like,
the people that take the,
oh, you got one of those?
He's talking about killing, like, killing that taking pictures.
He was
on
like, oh, okay. I was like, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So he take the pictures.
Okay, okay, okay. Mm-hmm. The one with the hand and the gold chain?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. He was out there. I was like,
that's dope.
You say out here now? Okay, my bad.
Yeah.
That's dope. We, yeah. Every time you get one of those in the club,
now you got followers and supporters.
Yeah, I got people going.
I ain't gonna lie. Yesterday I got a DM from somebody from New York. It was like, oh, yeah. He was like, I'm running for mayor. If I win, he said, I see what you're doing over there. You know what happened with the kid that got banged and with
with the
police.
I
shared it. He was like, yeah, I see you. You know,
Junior was his name.
Yeah,
Junior.
Something like that. Juno. Junior. And he was like, yo, I see you doing stuff for the community and you're trying to aware people of what's going on and
yeah,
stuff.
That's
so
what I mean.
He was like, if I won the mayorship over here in New York, I'm going to give you the key to the city. He told me that.
That's
straight
nice.
Up.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
I said, hey.
Oh, Sean, get into politics. Let's go.
Uh-oh.
Nah, I ain't no
politics. I told you I'm going to be the first million and I said this already.
Right?
I take a key to the city. I ain't doing no politics though.
Nobody.
No.
Yeah.
I forgot. Conspiracy.
That'd be dope. Nah. Not even. Nah.
My favorite move in life is you go to getting political.
Oh no.
Yeah.
If you go political, it's like you either God or the devil.
Right. I'm not doing that. We're not doing political. So. But it'd be dope to go to New York and receive that key.
Right. That'd be dope. That's a nice experience. Yeah. And you go to New York, get all the New York fans.
Man, so it's dope, man. You know, the platform is definitely great here. You know what I mean? And people been asking me about co-hosting on Saturday. I'm like, look, I'm looking for somebody, but you know, gotta be somebody that knows some things.
Right.
So yeah, they've been approaching me heavy. So we'll see what happens with that.
Yeah,
I'm with it.
Yeah, you know, but right, Mondays, Fatima,
man.
My baby.
I like Mondays.
Yeah, Mondays is chill, Mondays is dope. You know, we get to talk to a lot of artists.
Right, I like Mondays. I got an artist coming in two weeks from now.
Yeah, we got another one coming in 2 weeks from now, and we got another one next week.
Next week?
Yeah.
Talia
Music. Yeah.
Okay. Well, Spanish is Talia.
Talia Music. She dope person. I had her host one time at Cafe Iguanas.
All right.
Real cool. Sexy.
She was very pretty. Christ. I was like, damn. The girl from today looks hot too. I'm like, damn, girl, where are you going, girl?
Girl, sexy, girl.
I was like, yeah.
But yeah, she. I guess a hair, yeah. She bad, bro. She's real short, but.
She bad. Ooh, those are spicy ones.
Oh, yeah, like spicy nachos.
Yeah. Like the Brittany Murphy girl that got punched in the face by Remy Ma.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nah, but like,
nah, that's gangster.
When they had
Remy or the little girl?
Both.
But when they had
Catch Me Outside type shit.
Catch Me Outside. But I think it's a thrash shit.
I did see at Twana Don posted something about the boy and said that at 5 o'clock they want to do some kind of a rally to get the police fired.
Right?
At 5 o'clock, yeah, today. So they're gonna be over there probably doing protests or whatever.
That's good, okay.
I mean, he, I ain't gonna lie, he deserved to be fired for that. That was bad.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Oh, go ahead. I just
see I was like, wait, no, I'm just saying.
Okay. Well, basically, in 2020, they are aiming for presidential hopeful Elizabeth Warren. You know, basically, she's releasing a plan to wipe out student loan debt and make college free.
Oh, yeah, I'm
is it Warren as in Warren?
I'm definitely voting for her.
I need
my side student loans out of here.
We need Trump to go.
For 2020, she's trying to get it where college
said we need Trump.
We need Trump to go.
Yeah, hell yeah.
He needs Trump to
get out of here.
You thought she said she was vibing with him?
No, I'm not vibing with him. He's Gemini. He a Gemini like me, you know what I'm saying?
Trump, boy, he funny as hell.
He just,
He be tweeting some crazy shit on Twitter, man.
You should be that. He's a little ratchet. He's like a ratchet. He's like a ratchet for them. Like, you too ratchet for this. So you gotta stop with
dork.
This Twitter thing. Like,
yeah.
He's a huge dork.
He put a Game of Thrones thing on Twitter talking about,
I'm like,
man.
What a clown.
Yeah.
I'm like, stop. And I think Game of Thrones came out publicly saying, like, hey, stop using our thing.
For real?
Yeah.
That's
like,
funny.
Can you please stop
nobody
using?
Fucks with you.
Damn. Yeah, like nobody likes you, so we don't fuck with you either. Like, you know,
that's
so
funny. Wow. Jeff. Damn. I wouldn't imagine that. That's funny.
Poor Jeff. Yeah.
Fuck Trump, man. You don't care about him.
Yeah.
I'm
he means probably, well.
He means well.
He means rich.
Yeah, the only thing that I don't like is he's all with the rich people and stuff and the whole taxes.
That's all he care about.
The whole taxes and thing, I'm not down with it.
He care about money.
That's
exactly.
It.
Exactly, he's more into money, so I mean.
That's it. Fuck that. Fuck Trump. Fuck everybody that support him. All that good stuff.
Fuck Donald Trump.
So, anything out there in the news that's been juicy?
Oh my god, there's so much stuff right now. We
talk to me.
Definitely have the Remy Ma punch in the face.
Damn.
And the update was that she did go ahead and tell the police, which I think is fucked up because she's on parole, you know? So anything can send her back to jail. I think that's kind of whack from Britney's part.
That's crazy.
Like, girl, if you got punched in the face, it's fair.
Britney,
it's one-on-one.
What Britney?
The girl from Lemon Hip Hop. The little one, she's like 4'10".
It's like 4'11 Hip Hops.
New York.
Oh, New York, okay.
The little one with the blue hair that had beef with Bianca.
Oh, that girl, is that...
I've been seeing her in Tori.
I thought that was Bianca, somebody else, right?
Brittany, that's Bianca and
okay.
Brittany.
Oh, the one that had beef with Bianca.
The one that has beef with Bianca.
Right, right. Okay.
That she's little, she always has the blue hair.
Yeah.
And then Bianca was like, bitch, I had a first bite.
Right.
That little girl, which I've also seen in a session with Tori Lanez. Been
she
in a studio session.
Face.
I saw her and Alexis Sky. I'm trying to get Alexis Sky on the show too, guys. I'm working on that. Right, I'm working on it. Wait, so I'm speaking into existence.
That's cool.
You know what I'm saying? I'm seeing her with Alexis Sky and Tori Lanez's little session. And she's really little. She's actually shorter than me. And I'm little. I'm a little person. But I don't agree with... Remy Ma's a Gemini like me too. I'm a Gemini. So
she punched...
Remy supposedly punched her in the face. Cause
Remy, okay.
Remy punched her in the face. She came out and put a video out that Remy punched her in the face. She had a purple eye. She came out on a live. And supposedly Remy punched her because... she was messing with Remy's daughter, or stepdaughter, which is Papoose's daughter.
But do you believe that, though?
I mean, Brittany said it was Remy directly, which I don't know why. Like, I mean, she's on parole, which is, I think, is fucked up. So now you're snitching, not only you're...
Why do you think Remy would do that if she knows she's on parole?
That's what I'm saying. Like, was it really Remy? Is she just claiming it was Remy's people?
Yeah.
I'm not really sure what's going on there.
Yeah, I don't know.
Allegedly.
There's so much false shit out there. I can't believe that.
She did get sucker punched though, really bad in the face. Like it's just boom, like a one good one. So I could imagine Remy punching her in the face.
Or somebody else.
Or somebody from Remy's clique who punched her in the face. But it's sad because Remy got a whole empire going on. She got clothing on.
Right. Why would she jeopardize that?
And you know what I'm saying? She got three shows.
The jail thing is big for her.
Parole. If she breaks her parole, she can go back and have to finish her original time.
That's why I don't think that Remy did it herself. I doubt it.
Probably one
of her goons, maybe.
One of her goons, yeah. But hey, she shot at somebody. So she shot at her home girl, so shit. Brittany had no... Brittany stood no chance.
Yeah, she crazy.
Gotcha.
She crazy. Man. Shout out to the playoffs, man. Anybody been on, you keep up on the playoffs? You what?
Oh, we were trying to catch it on Sunday, but we didn't have like a TV. How was it? Saturday, I think.
The games is nice, man. All the games that's I know that's boring is like the top seed, they going through it quick.
Running through
it. OKC is down 3-1. To they down 3-1 to who is it? Portland. So everybody thought OKC gonna win that series.
But I told you, little baller.
Yeah, little baller, he is.
A little more help on the big man side.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, they got
Kent, Marc Gasol.
He went over to Toronto.
Yeah, he is at Toronto.
They got cancer over there now. They got cancer some other place.
From Thompson.
Yeah. So cancer made a big difference with them now, and they beating the OKC bad, man.
And what about Mike Johnson?
Magic Johnson.
I know he left the Lakers.
He stepped down.
Supposedly working with them.
He stepped down because he couldn't get the power he wanted to get, basically.
Mm.
Yeah. The owner, Jeannie Buss,
mm-hmm.
she still wanted to run the show. She didn't want to give him. the power to do his job.
Was I?
So, he wanted to fire the coach, Luke Walton, and the GM. So
okay.
She said, no, you can't fire them. So he was like, you know what? If I can't if I can't do my thing, why am I even here? Like, and then on top of that, he wanted to train like people like Ben Simmons and other people.
Mm-hmm.
Could they reach out to him? So because he's a Lakers president, he couldn't accept the offers. So he's like, yeah, he can't do a lot of shit while he's a president. He said, you know what? I'm at Johnson. I got a whole bunch of businesses. I don't even be doing this.
Yeah.
I don't blame him.
He did say he was gonna help.
He just taking the leash off his neck.
Right. That's all he did.
He said that he was still gonna help the team and whatever they needed.
The team, but not everybody else on other teams. Okay. They want his help. So
okay.
He wanted to be able to do whatever he wants, basically.
Okay.
As a man, I don't blame him.
Have you guys seen The Homecoming though by Beyonce?
No, I haven't.
Fucking best thing on Netflix right now.
Yeah. I'm gonna watch it though. It's on Netflix. I'm gonna watch
it. Yes, I've watched it like 4 or 5 times getting ready. Stop it.
I did get a chance to hear the remix she made Before I Let Go, which was dope. I don't know if Mar heard it.
Yeah, oh my god, everything is I care. Oh my god. Dope.
Beyonce killed that.
She a queen. How the hell she come up with a freaking Netflix series of her concert and make it that gangster?
Celine Dion did that. Anybody want to remix that? I give her.
She basically got all her old tracks and made a fucking new one. Like, goddamn, she's popping.
You know she got a new contract with Netflix for 20 mil?
Yeah.
Nice.
No wonder. Mm-hmm. Is she going to be doing specials with her probably?
Mm-hmm.
She's copying Celine Dion did that.
Well, a lot of the big timers are doing Netflix specials for 20 million. Kevin Hart got one 20 million. Like, it's a couple of them.
I like it.
Yeah.
But it came out so good, like it's really good. Like what?
Yeah.
Like it's like a dance thing, but it's also like a story. It's fucking awesome. Like,
but I heard it
made you cry.
I heard Coachella tried her.
Yeah.
They paid the girl more, Ariana Grande, more money than her.
Yeah.
And she, Ariana Grande's sound got all messed up, and then Beyonce was just on point. So
Beyonce was perfect.
Yeah.
God damn, it was perfect. Like, I don't even think
Beyonce.
I don't think the choreographers even messed up. They called it Beychella. They named the whole thing Beychella. Yeah. That's how raw she was.
How are you paying her more than her? How is that possible?
Right? And she has a whole marching band that she gotta pay, and a whole squad of people that she gotta pay.
That's crazy. That's some politics shit. I'm sorry. There's no way you paying Ariana Grande, who's a great pop singer.
Yeah, she's a great Beyonce, boy. She can't definitely not dance at Beyonce. She sucks. She done fall in love
a
day. She falling around.
Now, listen.
I love her voice.
I'm gonna show love to her because she's from hometown. She's from Florida. That's the only reason why I show love to Ariana Grande. But besides that, I mean, come on.
I mean, I fuck with her. I like her music.
Yeah, she has no music.
I didn't like the fact that she stuck her finger in a donut a long time ago. That's fucking nasty. I don't know where she learned that from. But aside from that, I like her. It's just I don't like. No, not she's not better than Beyonce. She doesn't dance like that either. She don't dance like that. Took her 4 months, this lady, to get her shit together. If you really watch that, it shows you exactly step by step what she did to get to that concert ready. She just had given birth. She said she was 200 pounds. We was like, girl, stop.
I thought the homecoming was like her new album she was dropping or something like that.
It was kind of
her album.
Okay, it is an album. She dropped those announcements on iTunes. It's on iTunes.
Okay.
The Homecoming, which is the whole remix of the actual Netflix special.
Hmm.
Which is dope. But that shit was the hardest thing ever. She collabed with a bunch of young students and ended up, you know, putting some flow.
Only Beyonce do shit like that.
She was epic.
She
had a whole marching band. I was like, epic. Stop, girl.
Barely any promotion. She's going to drop it and shit going to go crazy.
She didn't even need a promotion. She didn't make an album or nothing. She was like, let me just grab all my old songs.
She did a pop-up album. She don't need no promotion.
Right.
No.
She don't need no promotion. All she got to do is drop that one time. Out right now on Netflix. It's over with.
It did. That's just how it happened. One day it was like Homecoming, Netflix. What?
Easy. Crazy. You know, if they cut up 20 million, they're going to make a billion.
Right.
Yeah. You know how many people watch that stuff? Mm-hmm. Are still watching it now? Tripping.
Yeah. And I want to thank Chances for hooking us up with unlimited Netflix. But
shout out Chances. What's up?
Tell Chance to come on any record. I need to talk to him.
Chances.
He needs to come here. Give me a chance.
We don't want to come back here no time soon. Just playing. Chances was an awesome co-host.
She was the host before you.
Yeah, Chance. sister.
Okay.
Yeah, she's dope. But she's doing her thing right now. I'm not sure if she's in New York or Atlanta right now.
Damn.
One of them two.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, she's doing her thing then.
Yeah.
Well, I got an interview for Cox, surprise.
Cool.
Cox Media, so you know.
Okay. Yeah, you got an interview with Cox?
Maybe, if I want to call me back, I'm going to call me back. Hopefully they call me back. That's and then cool. I can get all the concert tickets. We in there. I got all the inside scoop for real now. I'll be in the concerts. I'm like, what's up?
Well, I mean, look. Cox is
That's nice. This is like something also, you know, throw on top of it.
Yeah.
We'll do a bunch of things.
I mean, it depends on the position.
No, I get to do all the concert stuff.
Oh, okay.
That's fun. That's dope. I get access to everything. Wherever y'all want to go, they go to Rolling Loud, we're going. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, hell yeah.
Please call me before this. Please, I have
backstage passes. Speaking of that, I got an artist that's performing now.
Oh, yeah?
And you're going to take us because we are your dogs. Yes, you know they got a certain number of artists.
I've never been to Rolling Loud.
I can be a background dancer.
Yeah.
I'll be doing that shit. You know what I'm saying?
I heard this is nice though. Yeah, and I heard
it,
the concert.
I went with Small Perp 1 year. What was it like? Oh yeah, it was dope as fuck. We were on stage. It was so dope. I'm not even gonna lie, but we were in California though. We did it in Cali. So a bunch of Florida people meeting up in Cali. We were like, yeah. It was like the dopest experience ever.
But you probably had a free ticket though.
No, we went in with Smoker. We were driving around on the thing. We were with them, we were like the entourage. We were like, woo, in a little golf cart with our hands up.
A normal person that don't got connects, it's expensive tickets.
Yeah, no, but don't get it twisted. It's really hard to, even if you have a connect, it's hard to get it.
Yeah.
You gotta finesse, you gotta be like, yo, you know, I know this person, and this person fucks with me.
But it's hard getting the backstage access. It's talking about like a regular concert, you probably get in there, right?
Yeah, but I don't wanna go there.
Nobody wants to be a regular.
Right,
I'm
of course.
Person. I rarely go to.
That's why I don't go, because I don't want to just go in the crowd and just nah.
I don't like that unless you're like
VIP. You know, I gotta be VIP when I go to shit like that. I gotta be backstage.
Of course, that's why I don't go unless it's
right.
Or unless it's like a private event that they're gonna be singing at. That's something else. Like Art Basel, when the artists go sing, it's like a one-on-one kind of type of thing. That whole concert shit, that ain't for me.
Yeah.
I'm not really enjoying it. They're not even playing the songs that I'm the one to play. Like no.
So. Of course, you know, guys, we got top 8 at 8 o'clock, so what we'll do, get into a short little music break while we go ahead and pay some bills, do some commercials, all that good stuff, and we'll come back, and then we'll go into the top 8, and then, of course, later on tonight, we got a special guest coming in, my girl Chrissy. It's going to be lit. Make sure y'all keep it locked. That's going to be about 9 o'clock, so we're going to take a little short music break, and we'll be back. Y'all keep it locked here at the radio. Two different ways you can go to Spreaker.com. If you're on the website, use a computer or our phone or whatever, you can go to Spreaker.com, Spreaker with an R, and / Hit Factory Radio. Or you can download the app, the Spreaker app, and search for Hit Factory Radio and then choose any show. We have a list of shows, everything that is on demand. So if you did miss any show, you can go back and check it from 3 to 4 years back since we first started.
And interviews.
Hey. Definitely. Exactly. So, with that being said, we'll go ahead and jump into the top 8, man. Ma, let's get it, my nigga.
You're now tuned in to Hit Factory's top 8 at 8.
Okay, so coming at the number 8 spot, we got the homie Lil Mosey, Greet Her.
You're now tuned in to Hit Factory's top 8 at 8.
I'm like, I ain't heard it sing. It was about 5 minutes ago. When I seen it, better be still. You ain't never been.
Factory's top 8 at 8.
Okay. Yeah, same thing I said last time I heard that. I'm like how he just took all Chris Brown lingo.
Wait, and he had to be lyrics too.
Yeah, that's crazy. But it's alright. Whatever. Coming to the number 7 spot, we got AO and TO featuring B. Smith, Friends.
Coming in number six, we got Bass with Purge.
Bass with Purge.
Dream shattering ceilings, they got me feeling myself like I'm fitting a belt. They never give me a chance, I never give them a break. Keep a foot on their neck, I go deeper than depths, submerged in it, I'm getting the urge. Nigga, I'm killing these niggas off, call me the purge. I speak.
Low-key O'Donnell's
had
a
sing.
He got a voice like
that. It is loud singing, you know what I'm saying? Just like a sing, you can get extra points.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Serenade these ladies.
Yes, sir. Serenade. Yeah, nah.
Sing to the pussy.
Oh, no. Whoa.
I'm sorry, I got the spirit of flies in me. My bad.
And you know that.
So, come in. At the number five spot, we got Gas Mask, Down and Out.
You're tuned into Hit Factory Radio 954. Coming up next in number four is Tory Lanez, Freaky.
So coming at the number three spot.
Three.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We got my little homie, Lil Free Love, we're back again.
Number two, we got JQ, Bobby Boucher.
All right, we have an announcement today from our former board of directors.
You're now tuned in to Hit Factory's Top 8 and 8.
Football.
To Hit Factory's Top 8 and 8.
Bobby Boucher.
Remember that movie? Bobby Boucher. Yeah. That shit was crazy. Yeah, so. Of course, y'all know how to do. Every Monday, we don't just jump right into number one because that's what lames do.
Right? You want to jump into number one?
We don't do that. We let y'all know. We run down for people that missed it, maybe possibly right, missed right. it, and we run it down and let you know. So the number eight spot, we have Lil Mosey, Reher.
Number seven, Ayo and Tayo featuring B. Smith, Friends.
Number six, we have Bass with Purge.
Number five, we got Gas Mask, Down and Out.
Number four, we had Tory Lanez with Freaky.
Number three, we got Not Free Love, Back Again.
Number two, we had JQ, the homie JQ with Bobby Boucher.
I'm gonna let you do this for sure.
And coming in at the number one spot. New number one, my lady. Twista, Tonight, It's Your Heart. Yeah, man, that was the title of the day. Number one, Twista shit go hard too. Shout out to everybody that voted. You know, everybody that's involved with the title of the day.
Right, shout out to everybody's tuning in right now.
All the artists, yeah.
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 Was it caught us live?
So we got some time until the guest comes. I got
one good juicy topic.
Go ahead. Let's talk about it.
Good thing that I want to hear.
I got
about
a question too for everybody.
Oh, so. I like your questions. I like your questions.
Yeah.
You want to do my little gossip first?
Yeah, let's do my little gossip.
Well, during these couple of days, have you heard the whole G Herbo and his baby mama, the real Kai sister?
No.
Going on. You know I'm going to bring it up. Yeah.
They've been hitting on women forever.
Who, G Herbo?
Yeah.
Yeah?
They say he hit his ex before that.
Oh, well, I'm not really sure. Oh, that's a different story. See, that makes me change my point of view. Because the videos that surface is, you see his baby mama popping off on him and he's running away from her and she's like literally popping off on him in the parking lot.
Oh, wow.
You haven't seen that video?
No, I didn't even get to see it.
Yeah, well, allegedly he got arrested in Atlanta for beating up his girl. What you think?
I heard that one, but I didn't know he had a video.
There's a video of her kind of hitting on him, like hard as shit.
I think anybody hit on a woman as far as a dude should face the consequences.
Well, G Herbo was arrested on Wednesday, April 17th for battery against his ex-girlfriend and the mother of his child, Arianna Fletcher.
So she beat herself up?
Well, she said that he kicked my door down to get in my house because I wouldn't let him in. Supposedly she had his jewelry though, so. Beat the fuck out of me in front of my son, she alleged. Then he took my son to his friend's and had him drive off with my son, hid all the knives in the house, broke my door, and locked me inside. Supposedly, he locked her inside and beat the fuck out of me again, choked me, punched me in my face, all over my body, dragged me outside on the concrete, by my hair, and after this, his friends drove off.
Well, that's a good story, but did anybody see it? Witnesses.
First of all, I need a picture of the real pastor.
If you say you still got dragged outside, then obviously there had to be some kind of witnesses to see that. Unless
outside was super
dead, I doubt it. You know what I mean?
I mean, come if you're on. Fighting someone, you're screaming.
Right, you're screaming, right? Come on,
supposedly
bro.
The cops, that shit don't make sense. There's another version that the cops came in and because when he kicked the door down, the alarm went off, so the cops obviously came, and that's where he got arrested. But supposedly she had his jewelry. But this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking that low key, he went to go smash one last time and he got fucked up because he left his jewelry there. Okay. She didn't want to give it back and she sent a picture to the girlfriend. And the girlfriend found out that he had fucked the baby mama. And then she was trying to, but you know, the baby mama should have done that, being a hater of the new relationship. And he got mad and hit her. That's my version of the story.
Damn.
That's what I think happened. Cause you know, the Latina, cause he was dating Latina, Fabulous' daughter.
Yeah.
You know? So supposedly she was writing on her, and she took all the pictures down of her and G Herbo and stuff, so. I don't think they're together at the moment, or maybe they are, I'm not sure.
That kind of sucks though, cause you know, she's dating that kind of guy versus her dad is going through the same shit.
Okay, right? Isn't that funny?
That is
ironic. Not funny, but ironic. Like funny in the irony of things, right?
Man, I can't believe that.
I don't think he really beat the fuck out of her like that, like she's saying though, because she posted it that he beat her up, like really beat her up.
It could be possible, you know.
That he dragged her and stuff? I need a picture though.
Yeah.
Y'all don't want a picture?
Like mother, like daughter, maybe.
You think?
Could be. Never know. Who knows? I mean, when it comes to the abusive relationships, now you gotta start thinking like it is some wild ass dudes and it's some wild ass people that provoke motherfuckers to do shit. So
yeah, maybe the baby mom provoked it, but maybe that's why he left her, you know, because she was too aggressive.
Aggressive. Yeah, could be.
I don't know.
Speaking of aggressive, Tiger dropped the lawsuit with Birdman for the $10 million.
He dropped it?
He dropped the lawsuit.
Why the fuck? Is he gonna, did he get money on the side?
I don't know how they doing it, but you know how Birdman is. He liable to be switching something up and setting something up for him to drop some music maybe. So
well, and he got bars too. It's plus, you know, got bars.
They bringing back Juvenile and Hot Boy Kirk and all that, so it's like you might want to catch this wave, because once Wayne get on the good foot of bringing everybody back in, it might be a, you know, bigger situation now.
Oh, tell me the big dogs are coming back.
Yeah, they might have to step down and let Wayne really lead the shit, you know.
I would love to hear some Wayne like back in the day. I don't know if he still got it.
Yeah, we do another Hot Boys album. That shit would be crazy.
That shit crazy.
But they gotta do a little Ratchet album. It has to be Ratchet.
It has to be New Orleans.
It has to be New Orleans, like with the beat and everything, like.
So
super rugged.
Big shout out to my dog Poncho, made it to the final three that the series is doing.
Okay.
B. Simone, yeah.
Okay. Made the final three. Yeah. He's gonna be the comedian?
Well, he's the final three. Yeah, he's
okay.
A comedian guy.
Yeah, so. Okay.
So hopefully he made the last cut.
That's
raw.
Woo!
That's dope.
Yeah. So
congrats on the final three. Hey, you made it to the final three? That's big anyway.
That's big anyway.
Shit. Speaking of big. Tell me why prosecutors are looking forward to YNW Melly. They're trying to get him a death penalty.
What? Damn. Fuck, he did that bad.
They say he killed his friends, right? You remember? When he got locked up, he killed two of his friends. Then supposedly they say he killed the police.
Damn, and he's like the top artist to look at too. Trouble. It sucks.
If he killed the police, that's one thing you don't do.
I have a question. How come every rapper that becomes a rapper right before they pop off, they go to jail? I'm like, damn. Yeah, your song didn't get popular. Boom, you're going to jail. How is that even, like, how are the odds that you're going to jail, but you're also popping?
I don't want
to
talk about it. Look,
nah, they know you.
Come on, tell me your conspiracy theories. I want to know.
I'm going to say it just on.
It's a part of something.
No conspiracy theory right now, as far as what I'm going
to
say.
They all go to jail for some reason, though.
But basically, they don't know when the music going to pop, right? You drop music, you don't know when somebody going to give you a call and say, this is the shit. This is the one that's going to take you over. So when they find out, their life still is their life.
True.
Now they got the possible chance of getting it changed. Now, they still ain't got no money yet. They just getting a buzz. Mm-hmm. So when they get the money, they're gonna probably.
So basically, you're saying that the jail card is the way to get the buzz flowing a little bit.
Not even. Basically, people are criminals. People do some fucked up shit. But because now they gotta be in a public eye, people start background checking them. So as soon as you think you're gonna get that almighty dollar, let's see what the fuck you got going on first before we give you our money. You feel me? So that's why they put a lot of people background, like.
Yeah,
but no, even when they've been in music for a while, like Gucci, he went to jail for a couple of years. Boosie.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's self-explanatory. He gonna snitch on himself. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They dry snitching, do all that crazy shit on their own. But if they need somebody to find some real research, they'll do it.
Like, I just think that it's fishy that every rapper go to jail.
Every rapper goes to jail before. Fuck. Take it.
Yeah.
Hello? He's like, what, 12?
Jim literally did his charge.
How did he kill
somebody?
12, right? 13?
Yeah, he was 12 when he got locked up.
Yeah, get Kodak ass, get arrested every damn
couple
months.
Well, he's a target too, man. Come
on. He is a target.
Oh, he gotta stop with the dumb shit.
Yeah, but remember, he's on parole, right? Whatever.
Yeah,
so
he can't fuck up.
He can't do certain shit. Yeah.
I respect him. He don't smoke in the studio. And when he was not smoking, he didn't want people smoking around him. So.
Yeah, but the whole thing at the border.
Yeah, he's an idiot. He's fucking stupid.
Well, how could that?
You gotta look at him like, really,
dog?
Really?
He made us look crazy out here, man.
Speaking of looking crazy, T.I. adds some more sauce to the situation.
I see.
Oh, no.
Basically, Easter, you know, he bailed out 23 non-violent criminals.
Oh, okay.
I think he did that just to the bounce that's back nice. In this bullshit.
He trying to fight Kodak with this shit now. Nah, it shouldn't have took Kodak. To
right.
Do this.
Right.
He should have did that already. Each Easter bun.
Look at
this.
He's
out.
Fighting somebody that looks like freaking Lisa Simpson. Like, what the fuck,
and
man?
You know, when blunt.
He tried to do Super Saiyan.
Yep.
He just didn't realize his hair wasn't long enough for that. So he got the Lisa. So his hair gotta be longer for
this. Just got that much.
Alright, so
rough.
Before we, you know, top the special guest in a second. I want y'all to hear this video, and then I want us to react on it.
You have your question, right?
Well, it's basically on this.
Okay,
right. Let's see. Mark, can we get it up? Let's see if we can. Let's see if it's.
Ladies, it's 2019. Stop waiting on the dude to shoot his shot. If you like him and you want to holler at him, shoot your shot. I've never been the type to wait on somebody to put me down with someone for the middleman. No, none of that. If I see somebody, I'm gonna pull up on you. How about you try this? Next time you're in a club and you see a fine ass nigga at the bar, why don't you buy him a drink? I promise that'll fuck his whole head up. You can even roll up on him and be like, can I buy you a drink? Or you could do it like me and holler at the bartender and be like, tell that fine ass nigga to get what he wants, and I'm gonna pay for it. I know some of y'all like, I ain't spending no money on no nigga, bitch. The fuck I look like? But what's $14.50 to a nigga who could potentially be your new pay? I don't know. You don't know unless you try. And you know I'm out here making some money these days, bitch. If I see a nigga that's like, I'll buy a nigga a drink. What's up? And you set the tone in the relationship, boo. I don't need you. I want you. What's up? We can do this us thing. Let me compliment you. Let me compliment your swag. Let me upgrade you. Don't be that bitch at the bar. Waiting on a nigga buy you a drink. Buy his drink and your drink. What's up? Hey.
What you think?
Oh God.
that was Jazz. Watch Jazz. So you know she got a million followers. So she said some things.
I mean, I'm not gonna buy him a drink, but I'll holler at him. I'm down with that.
Why you go buy him a drink for?
Why am I gonna go buy him a drink for?
Why not?
No, he got the wrong idea. He said that he gonna be mooching off me. He gonna be mooching off his mama, not me.
That ain't the case. Listen.
Listen, guys, yeah, the guys get the wrong idea. Oh, she gonna give me money.
Every dude don't do that. Every dude don't think like that.
That's a lot of dudes.
That's crazy.
That's a boy.
Dog, okay. If a woman says, you know what, I like you, whatever, or I fuck with you, whatever, I'm gonna buy you a drink. It should be no issue with that at all. That don't mean that if y'all start talking that it's gonna go based off of that way. No, the man gonna still be the man, but he still sees that, okay, you know what, she approached me.
Shot, not as everybody such a gentleman like you, man. You probably would
not. I ain't say everybody.
See, that's why I said boys.
Right.
Those are boys that take it as, oh, I'm gonna be greedy because somebody paid for my drink. You know, just the same as if I buy a girl a drink, she think I love her. Nah, I'm just getting you a drink, baby.
Right.
We know this.
We're just having a drink.
The whole point behind it is 2000. Yeah, listen, what she said. It's 2019 now.
Yeah.
A lot of women are stuck in their ways. They don't want to change.
There's some girls that just sprinkly hoes that will still buy a drink.
No, there's hoes here that will pay me on this shit. I don't know what the fuck wrong with that.
That nigga all night. I want to fuck him.
Woo.
And go right up to him and say, listen, I
want to
buy what you tonight.
See,
can I buy you a drink?
You know what's funny? Y'all be thinking that in the club, but then y'all won't do anything until they approach you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, y'all be thinking it. I wouldn't want to fuck this dude. I promise.
Nah, but I've approached a guy. You know, he got my number right now. I did it old school. I wrote it down on a little piece of paper.
Oh, no.
No, it worked. Because you know what? They had forgotten my name the next day because I was drunk, but they got a little paper that said my name, so they remember. And they
called
me.
Oh, smart. No. I mean, everybody won't do it. But.
And I hollered at him. I saw him from across the room. I was like, oh, I gotta have that. That's mine.
See? So, what's the problem?
I had a battle with another girl. I was like, move.
Now, what if he'd had your number and then you'd have received a phone call from a female saying that she received it out of her dude pocket?
Ooh, well then, possibly.
Have you ever had a for your case, a girl call your phone, like, are you talking to my man?
Oh my God. Instagram all the time. What do you mean? All the time. Yo, men just don't know how to have girlfriends.
I had one dude hit my phone up.
Y'all just don't know how to be faithful.
That's not true.
Oh, not everybody. Not like just a big, huge majority.
See, but sometimes a man with power already brings a threat to a man that ain't bringing nothing to his relationship. He ain't even gotta be trying to hit on your girl, but because your girl smile at him a certain kind of way because of the power he got of who he is, that's gonna make another nigga insecure too.
Yeah,
you know, that is true. You know that these days a lot of men, they just don't want one woman. They want multiple women.
And women are just so accessible now. It's just like.
No, I'm just saying, they just want
options too.
Right. True. I mean,
It's a double-edged sword.
You want me to tell you what's wrong with that? You want me to tell you the main problem why things go wrong in relationships?
Thank you.
Poverty.
Oh, money. Oh, yeah, that's true.
Poverty. We struggle as individuals. And we try to, you know, even when we doing good and growing, we still missing certain things. You feel what I'm saying? So we try to attach ourselves to other people.
So
that's deep.
You think women?
So did you shit?
That's what you shit don't.
A lot of women, and I mean dudes do too. But see, most dudes, if the you know the pom-pom is still there, they're gonna stay regardless if the money is there or not. But for most women, if you lose your way, you may lose your job and stuff. Some of them may not stay around. Like they won't because you ain't got no finances.
Yeah.
You gotta think about it this way. Like, do you really wanna have a man that goes all the way down?
Well, things happen though. Yeah. So let's say
How about this?
But things don't have to happen. Things can you can be secure and not have
to about this? Okay, how about this?
Bam.
True.
We in a world where you at level. So where you managing to take care of life, the guy you meet, same thing, vice versa. What you got, he got. Same thing.
We're equal. Yeah,
everything is mutual. Now, you dating him, and let's just say y'all have future plans, which means probably whatever y'all doing now, twice as much to get y'all goal where y'all trying
to get. Exactly, because twice income.
Yeah, but see, y'all thinking the same, y'all moving the same because they're all already on the same level. Now suppose one or the other, say for instance, he bagging more business versus you still trying. And he trying to double up because the goal y'all agreed on is to reach this number. We gonna get this bigger house, this kind of setup, this, you know what I'm saying? So y'all setting up family goals.
Mm-hmm.
And because he's bagging more of the clientele that he said he was and you not, what's his position to do at that point?
Well, I should actually get a second job or something at that point, try to double up my money, I don't know.
Okay.
I highly doubt that he'll beat me, but at the end of the day, the guy has to have, you know, the bread. Because if I have more bread than my man, I'm sorry, you're my bitch. Period.
That's, I mean,
not all the time, but I mean, I feel like if I'm paying the rent, I'll pay everything.
No. But what if he's doing that?
Okay.
But like I said, something happens to him, right? And he may not have the savings or something.
Unless he has like an injury, which I would understand why he would not have that much money. Or that would be acceptable.
Let's say he has a career job.
But a bad career move, that's on you. You fucked up. You shouldn't have done that. Like maybe like a bad investment.
Sometimes the company may.
It was risky, you know.
What
about
layoff?
Well, that's not good. Okay, layoff. Okay.
Can't do nothing about layoff.
I don't want to date somebody that works. I want a businessman, owner. So, I mean, I wouldn't be doing anything. But let's say their business dies out or something. It depends. Maybe if they're prepared like me to have a backup plan.
So
have a backup plan to your
you can't, plan. But see, you can't want a man that is only a businessman unless you in the same position.
True.
Okay. Making sure you know.
We're working on all those things. All right. We're working on all the things. But he can be ahead of me and then I can learn from them.
True.
So I don't mind that.
True.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But what if he don't want to? If you ain't not ready, he on the
side. Right.
I mean, usually men don't want to teach you. They want you to depend on them.
But what if he don't want to teach you? He wants you ready already.
Damn, then I can't be with him. That sucks. It sucks if he really likes me and shit. Because I'm not going to, it sucks if he likes me. He can't,
I mean, I ain't going to lie.
That's like if I like a bum ass nigga and I'm like, damn, I can't date you because you're a bum. Like, you know, it's happened to me before, but it just doesn't work out.
Yeah.
Because I tried to get him out of their bumness and they didn't want to get out of their bumness.
You have
that
to let go of some of your rules.
You know, I really tried to help that person not be a bum no more and they didn't, like, they just.
Not that part. I'm talking about as far as you want to date a career guy. You want to just a guy with his own business and stuff.
I want a career guy. Like, it could be a career
You would
guy.
Take one.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would take one.
Would you take a fast food guy?
If he owned a fast food.
If he owned a fast food.
Yeah, of course.
He assistant manager.
She said owned, bruh.
I said owned.
What if he don't?
Assistant manager?
Assistant manager. Or he GM.
And then he plays a mystical piano. He's a genius in the piano? Maybe.
Nah, if he's a GM, he's making money. But if he's the manager.
General manager.
Yeah. GM is making money.
Well, it wouldn't fit with my lifestyle either. Like,
if he's a GM of McDonald's, you don't know what he making.
I have a lot of trouble people dating because of my lifestyle.
Why would I?
And my schedule.
GMs are busy. A lot of those career people, they have no time for nothing. Like,
yeah, careers are whatever. Yeah. Like, they're always busy doing this shit. Like,
they're slaves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there's a lot of women that I feel like they don't understand. And they're like, he don't call me all day because he's busy. Bitch, find a hobby. You're like, you know, like, go start sewing or go cook.
Yeah.
Work out.
Yeah.
You know, do Pilates.
I don't lie. I'm, you know.
Because I be so busy. I'm like, you know how busy I am that I can't really like answer to all y'all. So y'all have to give me a minute.
Congrats to my best friend. She took that leap of faith, man. She quit her two jobs.
And
she's focused on her business, her online boutique store only.
I'm telling you.
So, hey man, I was shocked when she made an announcement. I was like, wow, that's tough.
I'm proud of her. Yeah,
that's tough.
Okay.
It's tough to jump, man. But sometimes you gotta just jump.
Jump real.
It's real now.
And jump will wake your ass up.
Yeah,
now.
It will. You gotta hustle even more now. Like me, I don't, bro, I'm only hustling. That's it. I ain't got time for, if I'm dealing with a chick, okay, I'll make time to,
you now know. You see how I be thinking, like, bro, I ain't got time.
Yeah, I gotta be hustling now,
I don't have time for that either, I ain't gonna lie. I mean, if it comes, it comes, I'm open to it, but they have to help me, or maybe we have to have, like, some type of thing in common. Because, you know, I'm trying to date other people that are not, like, in my feet. I just don't get it.
Sometimes
don't
understand. Distraction take you away from the bag, man.
Yeah.
True. I don't want to get unfocused on my bag. I want my bag first.
Yeah, man.
Once I get my bag, then I can worry about having a boyfriend and shit.
That's why these girls be hitting me up. I be like, man, look, I'm working all day. I'll be free at a certain time. I give them a time limit. You can't, if you ain't free at that time, oh well.
That's what I be like, I'm sorry.
That's how I am, but like, hey, I'm out here getting this bag, so I can't be doing nothing until that certain time. After that time, we can chill, vibe, whatever, but back come first, man.
Get to the bag, ladies. Get to the bag.
If they don't call when I get off, then I'm going to the booty club.
Right.
How about that?
Yeah.
Catch me outside.
Facts.
Mm-hmm.
Facts. Speaking of booty club, make sure she fight every Saturday. Come holla at your boy, man. You there?
Oh, yeah, man. Oh, also, we gonna have some tickets to give away for Money Bag, yo.
At, what?
Bruno's coming up real soon.
Oh, shit.
Sometime.
Are you guys gonna go to that?
Yeah, we got free tickets there, right? I'm out that bit. Let's go.
We Gucci.
Yeah.
We gonna be giving away tickets.
You know?
It's my birthday weekend.
Oh, Memorial Day
week is always my birthday.
All right.
It's a hot mess.
Uh-oh.
Everything's expensive. Hotels, flights, and shit. Oh my God. Everything goes up, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Rolling Out Month is coming, and
yep.
And we're going with you, Mom. Woo! Woo!
Yes,
look at her.
Yeah. I got you, bro.
Somebody told me, but I can't even make the announcement, so we good.
No, wait.
She tell me to tell y'all. Or anybody else
would
be good.
Set it up.
Take us with you.
The camera. Yeah. Cameraman. Hey, listen. Until she get here, let's get into some of that Wake and Bake now. Why not? That's some exclusive first.
Ooh.
You can hear, you know, right here first. Some Wake and Bake now. I heard some of it. It's dope. It's dope. So let's hear some Lick and Bake. Shout out to my stoners, man.
Hell.
Alright, hold on, let me get to the first track.
Yeah. Make sure, you know, her mic on voice mom.
Oh yeah, she good.
Yeah? Okay. So go ahead, introduce yourself.
Hey guys, it's Chrissy Celeste from Miami. Came to shut this shit down. Came to shut this shit down real quick. Where can everybody listen?
There is a link. I'll send it to you DM right now and then you can get it. All right.
Yeah. But y'all follow Hit Factory Radio 954 right now.
Right now.
Y'all follow them and y'all tune the fuck in.
Links in the bio.
Yeah, yeah, link is in their bio to listen live.
I'm gonna send a link right now and you can share it with your people too as well. Mm-hmm. So,
I'm gonna have to exit and come back in.
Good.
Y'all know I'm kind of late, but you know, I came with a gift. Florida County.
She can't embarrass me later.
You got that rum.
That's not your rum.
Nicaraguan rum.
Flor de caña. Yeah, that Nicaraguan. Ooh.
It's nice.
You know about the stuff.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's nice. Yeah, it's not bad.
That should fuck you up.
It could?
No, it will. Nicaraguans drink that like water. That's water to them.
Oh, okay.
They be drinking like.
What are you?
I'm Venezuelan.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm Nicaraguan. That's why I have.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, shout out Nika people. Wow.
Uh-oh.
Hey. I have some retirees.
Better than me.
Spanish
I had noodles today.
Yes, indeed.
What's up?
So tell me, what's your birthday? Is it November, right?
It's August.
August what?
20th.
20.
I'm a Leo.
Leo. And I think that's a sign.
I'm Leo's crazy. I heard
we got a Leo in the building.
I heard of Leo's crazy now.
No,
I'm not crazy.
I have my best friend's a Leo.
And
what are you? I'm a Gemini.
Ooh. Iffy.
I always get that, yeah. Gemini.
Yeah, y'all two-faced. My brother and my mom is both Geminis, and it's like, you know, I could joke with them one day and it's funny, the next day I joke with them, it's not funny. It's like, you know what?
Yeah, we be like that. But we get along with Leos though, for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be cool. I'm kicking.
My best friend, Leo.
Libra, okay, Libra, Leo, okay, yeah.
I like Libras.
Yeah, Libra, okay.
And what are you?
Sag.
Sagittarius. Fire. Yeah, I like Sag. We both fire signs.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So tell us about the music.
So y'all follow me on SoundCloud, Chrissy Celeste. This is new. I just started rapping 4 months ago. I mean, I always wanted to do it. Like, I always play freestyle every time I drink, have fun, blah, blah, blah. But like, if you go on my YouTube, I have old stuff from like 7-5 years ago where I was trying to do it. But I feel like now is the perfect time to do it because, you know, it's other female artists making it a wave. So it's easier to jump in. So I was always talking about it and I was always gonna do it, but I feel like I've been more motivated. Like, this time around.
Okay. And who do you look forward to working with as artist-wise, collabs?
I'll work with anybody that want to work with me.
Okay. That's sweet. Anybody from Miami in particular?
Yeah. It's a lot of Miami people out here that's working, like Stepsisters, Jayla, Ari. She sings, but she's good. She's up there. You know, Trina. I just met Trina like at an event the other day. We took a picture and everything, but I ain't leave that impact. Next time, probably I'll leave that impact.
Right. Okay.
But yeah, I don't mind working with like different females.
Okay. Any guys?
Guys? Oh my gosh, there's a lot of guys down here doing their thing.
Right.
And a lot been showing me love as well. Like I could say, Major Now was just on here. I love his music, Tapia, good music. It's a lot of people, Zoe Dollaz, like I did a song with him.
Okay.
It's just like a lot of stuff like under wraps, like.
Okay.
But yeah.
And what you rep? Are you from Broward?
I'm from Miami.
Miami? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
305.
What part?
I went to Northern.
Northern?
Okay. If I be like Kara City, everybody, oh, you went to Kara City? No, I didn't go to Kara City. I went to Northern. Okay. But I don't rep Northern like that either. But that's my school.
Okay. Dead.
You fought with other artists you mentioned.
Yeah.
Major Nine.
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely Major Nine. He doing his thing.
Yeah, he definitely doing his thing. Oh, we gonna be in Tally this week. This weekend. Miami Boys weekend.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a lot of Miami boys. Yeah. We're supposed to be hosting me and the other girls that rap, Tiara, Jayla. We gonna be out there hosting. It's gonna be like a Miami girls invasion. It's gonna be cool.
Damn. It sounds lit.
Yeah,
it is. You know, this is like the 11th year anniversary they did it. They've been doing it. Like, I used to go to school in Tally. And, like, I feel like Miami Boys is like another homecoming. Like, it's big. It's a lot of people. Like, it's been times where they shut down one pool party and we go to another location. Like, it's always been.
Damn.
It's always
been. Okay, Tally.
I'm
about to slide over there.
Hold on. I know about it already. I ain't going to speak on it.
Oh, you remind me?
Oh,
hell no. Oh, shit. My bad.
Yeah.
And you went to school out there? What'd you go to school for?
Yeah, I went to school for public relations.
Okay, did you finish?
No, I didn't. It was like I had to make money. I was more interested in making money. So,
exactly.
Like when I was in Tally, that's what motivated me to start my own business. And
okay, that's good.
So when I started my business, it was just like I didn't know. I would say I didn't know how to focus on the two, but I was so much more focused on my money. I wasn't really focused on school. So it was just like, all right, let me come back to Miami, do my thing. Like, you know, I got a shop down here now.
Yeah,
so I feel like it all worked.
Huh? What's the shop name?
Celestial Beauty Lounge.
Okay.
So yeah, that's in Miami Gardens on 183rd and 7th Ave.
I bet my career.
Y'all pull up.
Shout out to the boss chicks, man.
Right, boss lady.
1000%.
Damn, and your nails are fleek, girl.
Thank you.
Oh, God damn, they all fleek.
Yeah. The Gucci shades on.
I just got them today, y'all. Just for this interview. No.
Shit.
I'm taking sugar mama applications.
Sugar mama applications, man. No doubt, fool, but
please pardon the camera guy.
So, what made you want to, start taking it serious now?
Well, honestly, it's a couple different reasons. It was a time where I lost somebody that wanted me to do it, and like they died, so I felt like, dang, like I was really like sad about it. And just when I was like, dang, I should have did it. I should have done it. Like, and then my friends was trying to cheer me up, and they was just like, you should do this and you should do that. And I was like, you know what? Let me just write something real quick. And I wrote something. I was like, I need to record this. Like, let me record it. Blah, blah, blah. And that was one way. It's like the influence of my friends versus me being sad about, because it's like, dang, what am I going to do to like pass my time? Because even when I'm working, I'm sad. Even when I'm doing lashes at my shop, I'm sad. So it's like me doing music is something I really like. Like it'll be times where I come up with a bar, I'm like, whoa, how did I make this up? Like, it's lit. Like, stuff like that is lit to me. So I feel like that took my mind off of it a lot. And yeah, my friends motivate me and help me, so that's cool.
Yeah. Oh, so you do lashes too,
girl? Yeah. Okay. I do make lashes and I do body sculpting.
Oh. Mm. Okay, we got the plug right here.
Yeah. Yes, I be hustling.
I'm gonna tell y'all.
I make a hustle.
I do.
Shit. 1000%.
Right. You got merch too? No.
Mm-mm.
Not right now.
Yet.
I like that. Not yet.
Yeah.
You got it.
It's coming out.
What's your new single that's coming out?
Honestly, I have a couple songs that, but it's just like, right now, y'all just gotta watch. Like, SoundCloud, I drop random freestyles and stuff. So, like, on SoundCloud, like, even that back that ass up, I just did a freestyle. It was like, I did it on my phone type stuff. Like, that wasn't planned. I just wrote it. I just woke up and said, I need to post something this week. Okay. And I wrote that and I posted it. So, it's just like, I know that I'm gonna have, I have a EP that I'm working on, but I feel like it's not gonna come out till this summer. But I'm still gonna be on y'all ass, so make sure y'all on my SoundCloud. Y'all listen to my stuff?
We have it here, right?
Well, we need to get you guys sent tomorrow. Right, the email I sent tomorrow.
Okay, I'm send it. I don't know which one I want to send though.
We need more than one.
Turn up.
We need more.
We're drinking out here.
We need at least two or three songs.
Yeah, I'm hot. I done took this shot.
I know it's gonna be real warm. I'm like,
son. We need a couple tracks, man.
So, what y'all want me to send it?
DM? Yeah, send it tomorrow.
Send them all?
DJ YoMall at gmail.com.
All right. I want to do, I'm gonna make out.
I got Back That Ass Up.
Oh, yeah, I play Back That Ass Up. That's my shit. That's my favorite one so far. Well, I feel like every time I drop a song, it's always my favorite. So, I drop another one and it's my favorite too. So, I don't know if it's really my favorite for real. But for now,
yeah, we can run it. You want to introduce the track?
So, y'all, this is Back That Ass Up by me, Chris Celeste. Drop that shit. Hey. Chris Celeste.
This is a Hit Factory Radio.
I will knock a bitch off balance, I ain't talking about a pig. It's easy, bitches, yeah, it's a piece of cheesecake. These bitches know I'm winning and I never joined the sweet face. And I'm a business woman, keep my toolie in my briefcase. Got rich bitches on me, wanna smack, get it, we pay. And we'll be in the comments and the button that's a PH. Got some bad hoes on me, with the he say, she say, ABC, ass raps, bitches sound like he with pre-K. This bitch ain't like me, but now she wanna be gay. Now get all the time on this, I think it's like Felipe. Oh, nah, say Felipe.
Yo, that's joint art.
Got more than a bag in the days of the week. And I'm by my business, yeah, I got it.
LLC. I couldn't get it for you, man. I was trying to get
you. Yeah. Do you need
number 6? I was struggling.
I'm
moving back.
Pull that shit out. Had these rap bitches ducking.
the cops, now you really be fucking. Bitches burnt out, but they ain't hating in public. I wish I kiss my ass, but I want for you to suck it. And if it ain't my money, bitch, switch the subject. Bitch, bitch, stop testing for a little bit of fame. And bomb ass, cause stop playing on my name.
Bitch, bitch, stop testing for a little bit of fame.
Bitch, hey, and tell her get her cash up.
If you a bad bitch, go back that ass up. And if a bitch, hey, and tell her get her cash up.
This is the Hit Factory Radio.
I gotta watch the video. I had twerking. Did you do it on your phone? Yeah. Wait, what did I do on my phone? The song? You said you did it on your phone? No, no, no. When I say I did it on my phone, I recorded it on my phone. Yeah. Cause I did like a little video. It was like a little, like, I wanted to do it in one take, but I thought you did the song. I'm like, damn, did it on your phone? No, I did it at Josh LaBanks studio. Okay, okay, pretty cool with mixing and stuff. Yeah, that's good. Oh, good. I recorded it. Thank you.
Yeah, okay, I got you that video, man. We got a, hey listen, we gotta work a way to get that to Hydration Sundays, one of these Sundays. Yeah, Hydration Sunday. Yeah, it's a day party we do here in Broward County every Sunday.
And I'm not, I never got invited.
Well, you can get invited this week.
Okay. No, this week I'm gonna be in Tally.
Look at me.
Oh yeah, you're gonna be in Tally.
Okay, well, when I come back, we done.
What's a good Sunday?
What's a good Sunday?
Yeah.
The Sunday after that, I think yeah. The Sunday after that.
Let's do a single release. Section okay. Table, all that.
Oh, that's what I like. Yeah, let's do that. That's what we're doing. That's what we're doing.
All right. I'm rocking with it.
Thanks, y'all.
Yeah, I'm down.
It's another song. Bad Bitch. Everybody likes that song.
You already sent it to Ma or no?
I'm gonna send it to him right now. So listen, with that song, it was like, okay. With that song.
I got it.
Oh, you do? Great. So I don't gotta exit. So with that song, it was just like, I asked my friend, like, I was just wanting to rap. And I feel like nobody was really taking me serious. Like, girl, okay, whatever, whatever. So it had to, basically, I just went in my homeboy studio session and I was like, it was a beat and I'm like, let me do this beat. Let me get on it. And he was like, all right. And I got on it. So, I mean, when you listen to it, it sounds like I just did that shit in one take. But, like, you know, now that I've been doing it, like, I know, like, I'm a perfectionist now. So I'll be like, oh my God, I hate listening to it. Like, I want to record it over, but it's got so many, like, views and shit. It's like, don't even really make no sense. Honestly.
Okay.
That's an important one. Okay. Thank you. A lot of people like that one.
Sean, homie, you ever heard? I'm freaking out, yeah.
That's right, that more for like the Buddha Club, though.
Yeah.
You say what?
The strip club.
For like the Buddha Club, yeah.
The last song we just did?
Yeah, Bad Bitch.
Yeah.
That's Buddha Club right now.
Yeah, it's lit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, we
So, who's your inspirations, artist inspirations?
You know, I can really say, even though I don't think, I'm not gonna say she don't like me.
You know her?
But I love Nicki Minaj.
Maybe you don't, she don't like you.
She got me blocked, man. I don't wanna talk about it. But she got me blocked on Instagram.
She blocked you on Instagram?
Yeah. A couple years ago.
Why?
The fuck?
It was really, no. That's when, you know, she was with Meek Mill. I guess she didn't like my comment, but I didn't mean no harm.
So, what you said?
I don't want to talk about it.
Man.
If this resurfaces, because I already know what I'm going to tell her I said. No, I'm playing.
Why not?
She scratched the whole thing. No, okay. I'm going to tell y'all what really happened.
She's a
Sagittarius.
Yeah, she a fire sign.
So it was just like, she was just like, replying to everybody comments. So I'm like, ooh, let me say something so she can reply to me, and she blocked the shit out of me. But her ponytail was crooked, and I told her, your ponytail is crooked, sis. I never said like, oh, like that ugly ass head. I never said it, like, I just say your ponytail crooked. I still got the screenshot. But she blocked your boy. ain't even do nothing. But nah, I really like, I could, some of her songs, I could word for word, like, I like that she really talks about like pushing your pen and like really like having bars and stuff like that. So that's somebody like,
she's like the pioneer, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For the girls, you don't know.
Yeah.
Even though she is a little hostile.
So just Nicki, that's it?
I think, I mean, I like, you know, people coming up. What other? I could say Lil' Kim's cool. I'm not gonna say cool, like, she's legendary as well. Mm-hmm. Who else?
Lauryn Hill.
I like, I like Lauryn Hill.
Gemini.
Oh, she's Gemini too?
Yeah, she's Gemini. How crazy is.
So you are what, 90s baby? 80s baby?
Yeah, I'm a 90s baby.
Okay.
I'm a 90s baby.
Too young. Alright, so you've been, what, how many years you've been doing it? What, 5-6 years now?
I mean, I always, I even have some, like, songs on YouTube that I recorded in high school.
Mm. Damn.
So, yeah, I got, like, old stuff, but I never, like, really took it serious because back then when I was trying to get on the YouTube way, when YouTube had just popped in, Soulja Boy, so I was like, oh, let me do this, but I didn't really want to take it to, like, my MySpace or take it to my Instagram or nothing like that because I didn't know how other people would take it. Mm-hmm. So I feel like now, like, because back then you really didn't see a lot of up and coming female artists from Miami. Like, it's just the people who are set in stone. Trina,
Trick Daddy.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Like, so it was just like, all right.
Okay. That's
all right,
though.
How you feel about the scene now? Miami artists.
You like the city girls and stuff?
Yeah, I love them. I can actually say, like, that's one of the people that, like, inspired me because I felt like, damn, I never seen nobody, and that was something I had a conversation with my friend. I never seen nobody from Miami really make it besides,
yeah,
besides, like,
Trina.
Exactly. And Trick. And so when they did it, I was like, wow, that's really inspiring.
Yeah,
it's possible.
It.
Like,
it's possible.
It's like, I felt like, damn, I gotta move to Atlanta to pop. Well, I gotta go to another city.
Yeah, like LA or something.
Yeah, but it's just, you know, sometimes you just gotta put that work in.
Right? Yeah, we got this. Family gonna come through. D in the building, you know.
Yeah. Nah,
I'm sorry, bro.
No, listen. We got a lot of people from Miami coming.
We cousins.
You know, we show love. You artists. So love. I respect artists that do it. From Broward, from Miami.
Yeah, oh, and some Broward girls. I downloaded her thing. What is her name? Why I can't think about her name right now? That sucks.
But they like a bunch of girls. How much? Is it one girl, two?
It's
girls?
A female. It's a female. One? She rap up here in Broward. Damn. She from here. Hold up, let me find her.
Broward? Some name.
Right, that's what I mean.
Gabby?
Is it Gabby?
She dope? She's
dope. I can't think of her name. That sucks.
Charades.
I don't know who that is. At the Culture Tour concert, she performed.
Meet Gucci?
Yeah, she's from Miami. That's my dog too. Yeah, she got good music. It's a lot of people down here that's really working. That's somebody who reached out to me saying she wants to, like, make a song, like, a ladies' night. And I think that'll be good for down here. That'll be really dope. Mm-hmm. So.
And so, do you do theater and stuff like that?
At first I did. I was really into
Yeah, right? You used to act and stuff?
Yeah, what made you say that?
I had to do my little research, you know what I'm saying? Whenever somebody comes, I'm like, so, you used to be in the theater. So, you still act though or no?
No, I don't act. As much. I'm not as much. I don't act.
But
at
did
all.
You do theater, like, for real? Because theater is different from acting, like.
Yeah, theater. I did theater. I did more theater than I did. I actually was in, like, a couple plays before.
That's cool.
Like, yeah. Down here in Tallahassee.
Okay, that's dope.
Thanks. But yeah, with theater, you gotta be more dramatic and you gotta say. So, but I like.
Can you do, like, a little skit right now? Like a little acting skit?
Oh my god! Like that.
That'd be cool.
No, cause I feel like, you know, I did say I need to have a monologue that I know on the top of my head.
You don't know anyone's.
But I perform a couple of monologues, but none of was my ever, like, I never really had a favorite.
Oh,
where I'd be like, oh, I still remember this.
But this one was my favorite.
But like, if I have to prepare for one, trust me, I know I could. Which I'm not prepared right now. But if y'all want me to real quick.
Okay. I'll take that too.
But I ain't gonna do that.
Leo.
Oh my god.
Ooh. If you were acting.
But it's different because that's what I'm saying. With theater, they're watching you. like, you know, you just hear my voice, so they just gonna hear me like say some extra stuff, but they don't see, like how you see them on live, they see it. If it was on TV, I would have had y'all.
They gave me a script on that stuff too? Yeah.
Yeah, like if you wanna do theater, like you just have to remember it, recite it, right, whatever. So yeah, I had something on my page before, but I deleted it. No, it's not deleted, it's in my
archive.
Yeah. Hey. I was gonna say it wrong.
Right. Archive.
I was gonna say it too.
I've been corrected so many times, girl. I'm like,
so yeah, I have some like old stuff that I did, and it's really good. That's why I never deleted it, but okay, still, I might research it too. Okay. Like, it's on Facebook.
Bringing the acting back. You gotta do it all.
You should do it. Yeah.
Acting.
Yeah. You gotta do it all.
Yeah, that would be cool.
I've been in a movie and a web series.
Web series sounds fun.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Hey, boo.
Y'all know Talia's music?
I'm down.
Cool.
Talia.
She coming next week Monday.
Woo! Okay.
Yeah. That's funny. Yeah, that's the homie.
Hey, boo.
Coming next week Monday.
She just checked in.
Oh, yeah?
On live.
Tell her, man, look. We ready for next week, too.
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to be listening. Show up and show out. It's real cool.
Damn.
Nah, I got her one time for Cafe Iguanas.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was nice. Yeah, she did that thing. Yeah, she dope.
I did Cafe Iguanas one time. The other week.
Yeah?
But I feel like my favorite performance was Hookaholics, honestly.
Okay.
It wasn't a really big venue. It was like, y'all been in Hookaholics before?
Yes, that's my spot.
Oh, that's your spot.
Yeah, but they
move into another spot.
G5.
Huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, they was I liked that when I did that. That was my favorite show.
He was the cook. That was one of the cooks.
Oh yeah.
He did tacos. Yeah.
Oh, I ain't never tried them tacos.
What?
Tomorrow's food was good.
Tomorrow's Tuesday.
I gotta have a taco on a Tuesday.
Yeah,
there you go.
Okay. Hey, Chibachi open up this spot Tuesday too soon?
Our spot.
Well, you doing it too?
My bad.
Yeah,
I'm
part
of that. I didn't know that. Okay. Big money.
Yeah, just chill, man.
Big night.
The weekend,
Tuesday
after Cinco de Mayo.
It's gonna be at a GLA
lounge? Yeah, she's doing poolside Cinco de Mayo that Sunday.
Okay.
Oh, I like Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah. So it's gonna be lit lit.
I'm trying to get lit lit.
Matt, you pulling up?
When?
Cinco de Mayo.
Oh, of course. My birthday month. You don't be lit the whole month.
Yeah, the day party with the pool and everything, man.
Okay.
Real cool.
No way to go to Mayo. As long as there's food. Gotta have tacos. Oh. I have to have some Mexican food.
Some good taco. You gonna have all
Cinco
that.
Cinco de Mayo.
Gotta have some tacos.
Yeah.
Call Dell. Get the tacos in.
Hey, you gotta find a spot for Dell, man.
Hey.
On a regular Sunday, that trap be swinging though. Man, gonna watch.
Oh, yeah. Chibachi?
Yeah, hibachi rice and chicken.
Chibachi?
Do they do it on the pineapple?
Chibachi, yeah.
All of that.
Do they put it in the pineapple?
I'll show you.
No.
Stop it.
They put it with the rice or the noodles.
Oh, no, no. I want the pineapple. Like the pineapple. You know the pineapple with the rice that comes inside of it?
Yeah.
I like that. Oh,
that chibachi is amazing.
I'm telling you,
bro.
You gonna get every, man. Better than Benihana's, I can tell you that.
Better than Benihana's. I love Benihana's fire. But is it the same price?
No, it's cheaper.
Okay,
all right. You see,
Yeah, show her the plate.
Yeah, I showed her. She's nice. But I had the chicken on shrimp.
They got lobster, go steak, and all that. Shrimp. Yeah.
What?
All right, I'm pulling up off y'all face.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. It's good.
Real good.
Every time I go there, I gotta give me a plate of Chibachi. Every time.
Of course.
Yeah. So, yeah, man. Any more songs?
I'm ready for another track.
Yeah.
I got another song. It's kind of like, it was just a song that I was writing. Like, it was just like, it wasn't nothing where I felt like I have to have these crazy bars on it. It's just a laid back song where I just felt like, I'm not shit. Niggas ain't shit. I ain't either.
Yeah, okay.
So that's basically what that song was about. It's called I'm That Bitch. It's on my SoundCloud. I made a video to it. It's pretty cool. I really like it. I like all my songs. I can't be like, I like all my songs. I feel like I don't know. All my songs have different feelings too.
Okay.
Like. So you got that one?
I wanna hear that.
That's right.
I'm That Bitch.
This is the Hit Factory Radio.
Was hard too. Hold up.
Thank you.
That beat was hard.
Who you?
I tagged him.
Who you got doing the production?
I've been working with Josh Levine. Oh wait, producers.
Yeah.
Oh, I work with different producers. Like, that one, he changed his name, but I shouted him out on the YouTube video. But yeah, that beat is hard.
That beat cool.
Yeah. The other song, Bad Bitch. You can hear it in the tag. He shot himself out in the beginning. Mm-hmm. But that's not nobody I work. Like, I'm trying to find a producer where I could be like, okay, this is like, I had a producer that told me he could just come up, pull up to the studio when I'm there and basically whatever song, because I write my songs first and then I put it to a beat. Like, even with that song with Back That Ass Up, like, I didn't have no beat for it. I just wrote it. So I'm like, I go through different like instrumentals and I rap what I say, try to change the slow down. Da, da, da. It's like, nah, that's not it. Till I find it. So when people send me beats, like, I just feel like I'm so big on beats too. Like, that's why I like a lot of Detroit rappers, like Chief Keef stuff. Like, you know, sometimes it just be the beats that's just so hard. It don't even matter what you're saying, but I'm gonna try to make sure I'm still saying some good shit on
there. True.
But yeah, that's another thing. I'm big on beats, but like, do I have a producer locked in? No, I don't.
You should record on regular studios at
I did Circle House?
Yeah.
Circle House.
I think I did there before. They got a big gate in front.
Yeah.
I recorded. I recorded a song that's not even out yet.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, I just do like, I don't know, I haven't found, like, I just be going with the flow sometimes, y'all. I just wake up one day and be like, okay, I'm going to the studio tonight.
That's the best way to make music. That's when the best songs come out. When you're feeling it.
Right.
When you're really feeling it.
Yeah.
Okay.
When
so, really let the people know where they can find your music.
So y'all, you can find me on SoundCloud at Chrissy Celeste, KRISSYCELESS, SoundCloud, Instagram, Twitter, I'm the Detonator.
I'm about to follow you on Twitter real quick.
I be talking shit.
Yeah?
So follow at your own risk.
I'm following. Same name? What's the name?
The Detonator.
Oh, shit. I thought you were saying I was like a Detonator type shit, so. Okay.
The Detonator 3. Did you find it?
Nope.
And where can everybody find your music?
SoundCloud. Oh, y'all can go on YouTube and just type my name in too. I got like cute little visuals. I just dropped a vlog. My very first vlog, I dropped it last week. I'm just trying to drop something every week. So I don't even know what I'm dropping this week. Y'all tune the fuck in.
All right, for sure.
I need to stop that because I was on 103.5 The Beat and I was just like,
oh yeah.
Like, I've heard some of my songs, like, even with a lot of my songs, I have a lot of curse words in it too. So, Like, I did a clean version to the song that y'all said should be in the club. It's like, you know, my sound, it just sound crazy.
It's a big ass blank.
Yeah.
It's just a big.
But it's lit.
All right, any special requests or shout outs to anybody that's been helping you on your journey?
Oh, let me go ahead. I gotta shout out Fat Jesus. It's his birthday today.
Fat Jesus.
It's his birthday today. Next, the real Javon Mack. That's my best friend. He supports me on it. When the days I don't feel like doing nothing, he pushes me. Okay. So that's nothing. And everybody else that I fuck with. This is me making a video about it. Yeah. That's why I'm on that. Yeah, shout out to y'all for having me here.
Of course. You definitely won't keep in contact. Thanks, every, I was kind of like, some shit coming up. A lot of shit coming up.
Right?
A lot of shit coming up, yeah. We got performances, the culture coming up in July.
Right?
It's
lit.
Yeah.
Let's get it pumping.
So, you know, we handpick certain artists that we want to perform.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's going to be in Miami this time, right, Mom?
Ooh, yes. Yes.
So, perfect.
I'm going to put up on y'all.
Yeah.
Whether y'all want me to perform or not,
I still want to. I felt like that. That's real.
I mean, she might be too famous to want to do it, but us little people.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
She over here. We're going to get on moves.
Whoa, you got a verified check on your Twitter.
Duh. Yeah, I do. I just followed you, though.
But I'm famous.
I'm about to give you a shout out right now, you know what I'm saying? So.
Oh, my bad, Sean. Yeah. Oh, my bad.
Man, listen, I work hard for everything I get, my G.
You know.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't nothing given to nobody.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Facts. Facts. Yeah. Ma know what time it is. So,
are we wrapping this up?
Yeah. So, you said EP coming out? What day?
Yeah, this summer.
Summer? Okay.
So, y'all just stay tuned. Right. I'm kind of funny. I have a cool personality. Y'all can follow me.
Alright. Yeah, we followed you already. IG, I just follow on Twitter.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check out that blog because I love YouTube, so you know.
YouTube. Yes. So, alright, so there it is, man. We're gonna take some pics, pick it up with her.
Right.
So, we appreciate y'all for tuning in. Of course, if you missed the show, you can check it out on demand. Once the show ends, the link is there.
Yeah, in the bio.
It doesn't go away.
You never sent her the link?
I did.
You did?
But she was on live, so you know.
Okay.
So, once the show's over, she can share it and people can still listen to her. So,
yeah, it's on the man.
Yeah, of course, follow me Instagram Sean G Official, Twitter Sean G, Facebook Sean G. If you want any promotion, any marketing, artist, music, marketing, whatever, business marketing, holla at me. If you need radio spins, holla at me. Mm-hmm. We get the good packages going. And yeah, fuck with me,
okay. Damn. Well, my name is Fat. Y'all can find me on the gram.
Like, today's Fat.
Fat, baby. You know. Y'all can follow me on IG, Fatima That Baby. Anywhere else, I'm be Fatima, you know. And check out YouTube. Our videos are going to be pulled up this week. Damn.
Okay.
This interview and all the other ones as well. So, shout out to Odell. Ooh-hoo. Putting it all together. Damn. And I remembered this time. My freaking Cash App is Fatima Dragon. Drop that money in there. Ooh, I'm done. Drop the mic.
Yeah, shouts out to everybody tuning in, but follow me on the ground, the Serato Kid 954.
Can't move.
If you wanna do some business, talk some business, my email is djyamal@gmail.com. If you really buy some shit like right now, Cash App, $ Serato Kid, holla at your boy.
I remember.
Once again, we want to appreciate everybody for tuning in. And make sure you tune in for next week. Of course, we'll have a recap footage for this week's show. And new music to, you know, post and share to let everybody know what's going on out here. Rocking with Chrissy, you know, appreciate her for coming through.
Woo!
Yeah.
Thanks for having me, y'all.
Yeah, man.
Thank you for coming.
Much love and appreciate respect.
For real.
And of course, y'all know, we're going to talk about it next week. We'll be back in town. We'll be back live.
Yep. Entire music coming this week.
Right?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. And I guess we'll get a conversation maybe about how she turned up for the Mommy Boys weekend, you know?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Make sure you enjoy that too, man. Enjoy it for me because I can't make it. I got one leg right now, unfortunately.
Oh, yeah. Damn, no. Danielle.
How that happened?
Playing ball.
Yeah. You just gotta stick to the DJing, man.
Oh, Lord. That's what I bag at, though. So that's what I stuck with. I stuck with saying I'm sticking to the bag. So.
Exactly. Yeah. But I see you cool with DJ Chris. That's my dog.
Come on, I'm cool with everybody. I'm the coolest fan on the block.
Right.
All right. Yeah, man. He's a Hit Factory DJ.
He's part of the camp.
You do the show, yeah. When you came on Friday, you did a show with them.
Yeah.
The interview with them. Yeah, I remember that.
So, yeah, that's why I had to come back up with y'all one more time.
Oh, yeah, man. We good people, man.
Yeah, we fam over here, man.
Is it a little different than last time you came, too?
Is it?
I'm saying as far as how it looked. You know,
yeah, it changed.
A little bit.
Yeah.
That room got, you know,
remodeled. Well, yeah, this room will be obviously, yeah. But.
Wait for the little star lights. The little star lights. Gonna have that shit lit. I'm taking pictures there all the time.
Stop. But yeah, we appreciate everybody once again. And make sure y'all tune in next week. Until next time, peace.
Peace.